Namaskaram girls. In the previous class, I have started a new lesson, that is fiscal economics, public finance. The word fiscal derived from the Greek word which means basket, isn't it? Have you remembered fiscal economics or public finance? Under that we have five subdivisions, that is public expenditure, public revenue and public debt. Fiscal economics as fiscal, as financial administration and fiscal policies. In that we learn what is public expenditure and then character of public expenditure, causes for increase in the public expenditure. Today we are going to learn public revenue. Revenue means income. So we are going to study about the income, how the government gets income from different sources. So it occupies an important place, and the government has to perform several duties. Already I told, isn't it? Government is now the, our state is welfare state. The public is, the prime motive of public is welfare motive. So it has to spend more money for the public welfare. It to spend money, it needs money. So it has to get its income from different sources. So the amount of public revenue depends upon the expenditure that the government is going to be spent, isn't it? If it wants to spend more, it has to get more income. I already told you, private finance and the public finance, similarities and dissimilarities. The private, we fix the expenses based on the income. But the government first decide the expenditure, then raise its income. Already we studied. So, as the state is a welfare state, it has to do many welfare activities. For those welfare activities, it needs revenue. So, how it gets its revenue? We are going to study in the topic public revenue. So, according to Dalton, the term public revenue or public income in two sense. One is narrow, the another one is wide. In the sense of wide, it includes the income and receipts. Income or receipts which a public authority may secure during a period of time. That is collecting during a period of time. In the narrow sense, how they are collecting the income, the sources of income we are studying. Of a public authority. So how it's raised its income or the receipts during a period of time is called wider sense. How it gets a source of income is known as revenue resources. So to get a clarification, we can say this is public receipts. This is public revenue or public income. So, while it talks about the receipt, it includes about the loans and other things which the government raised, isn't it? The revenue which they are getting in the form of money. While we talking about in a wider sense, the public receipts includes the loans or the borrowings of the government from the internal and external sources. Now, let us see the sources of public income. How it gets the public revenue? They are getting the public revenue from two sources. One is tax, the another is non-tax. I already told you on the day, from the tax only the government is getting. Not only the tax, so many non-tax revenues are there for the government to raise. So, what do you mean by tax? Then you have to study the meaning of a tax, isn't it? Tax is a compulsory payment. This is the key word for this. Tax is a compulsory payment made by the citizen to the government. This is a compulsory payment. We cannot escape from paying the tax. We cannot ever the tax evasion, that also we will study. How they are not paying the tax, how they are escaping from paying the tax, everything we will study in this. But actually, what does the tax mean? Tax is a compulsory payment made made by the citizen to the government. For paying tax, we cannot get any benefits. Do we get any benefits personally from the government? For example, if you are paying monthly, yearly, you are paying 5,000 rupees or 10,000 rupees as an income tax. Just a think that you are paying rupees 5,000 as an income tax. IT pay pandrenge. Do you get any benefit by paying this IT? No, isn't it? So, this is a compulsory payment which every citizen has to do. It is one of their duties. We should not do evasion. Vari eipu, abdi solrala, vari kettama tappikirathu. We should not do that. As a citizen of a country, everyone, those who are eligible to pay the tax, they have to pay the tax. So, tax is a compulsory payment made by the citizen to the government. And definition of Murad and Dalton, they have given. Now we are going to see the features of tax or the characters of a tax. What the character is? First one is, it is a compulsory payment. So, the people on whom a tax is imposed must pay the tax. What I said, the definition, that is meaning is first they have given. This is a compulsory payment. So, the government, they, whom they are asking to pay the tax, they should not refuse to pay the tax. They have to pay the tax because refusal of payment is offense. What do you mean by offense? It's an offense. What do you mean by offense? Offense na dandane kuriya kutram. They should be punished, punishable. So, refusal to pay the tax is a punishable one. And there is no quid pro quo. That only I told. We cannot get any benefit from the government for paying the tax. There is no benefit between the. There is no correlation. There is no connection between the taxpayer and the government. The taxpayer, he cannot expect any benefit from the government for paying the tax. He cannot get any benefit. And the third one is, every tax involves sacrifice, isn't it? If you are paying monthly, yearly 10,000 or 15,000, that means you are sacrificing some amount of money to the government. So, every tax paying includes or involves some sacrifice. For this sacrifice, you cannot expect any benefit from the government. And it is not levied as a fine or penalty for breaking law. Tax is paid only for income, wealth or any other things. It is not paid or for fine or penalty. Don't consider this. Sometimes we are paying the fine and other things, isn't it? Nowadays, if you are not wearing helmet, you are not wearing the mask, the police are giving penalty to you, fine to you. You are paying 100 rupees or 200 rupees. That is not tax. So, tax is not a fine or penalty. It is a different one. And then, what are all the tax revenues that the government get? So, some of the taxes. What are all the taxes? You already know income tax, isn't it? Based on our income, we are paying. Second one, corporate tax that they are paying on their companies. That is corporate tax. Sales tax, which they be paid on the goods that we are purchasing. And surcharge, while you are getting some, purchasing some goods, they will ST, they will write surcharge tax. So, for the purchasing of goods, you will get VAT or surcharge tax. And CESS, these are the, these are some taxes. Tax revenue, some taxes, revenue of taxes. Non-tax revenue, what are all non-tax revenue? That is fee that they are collecting. Now I told, isn't it? Why they are going for, you are buying a license, you are paying money. To buy a driving license, you are paying money. Or to buy any government certificates, you are paying money. Isn't it income certificate? For a community certificate, you are paying money. to buy an Aadhaar, you are paying 50 rupees. That comes under the fee. And then second one is fine. That I told you now. If you are not wearing helmet or if you are not wearing mask, you are asked to pay fine. That also paid by the citizen to the government. And earnings from public enterprise. Earnings from the public enterprise. The government will get the public invest in public enterprises. The public enterprises, they will earn profit, and that amount also included in the revenue of the government. Then special assessment of betterment levy. Let me explain one by one in a detail. Just I'll give you the topics alone. Then give some grants, aids and other things. And the last one, HS. Now let me explain one by one of the non-tax revenue. Now let us see the non-tax revenue in detail. First one I already told you, fee. The service rendering by the government to the citizen. For that the government will impose some amount, that is called fee. For example, license. For rendering license to the citizen, we have to pay money for that, for getting the license. So fee is another important source of revenue to the government. It is charged for the public by the public authorities to the citizen for rendering the service, as I said, for issuing the driving license and to getting a passport, isn't it? We are paying money. So these are the service rendered by the government to the citizen. For that they are collecting some amount. That is called fee. The next one is fine. As I said already, for violation of law, for not wearing the helmet, for not wearing the mask, for not having the driving license and other things, the government is imposing fine to the citizen. That amount also as an income to the government. Then earnings from the public enterprises, the government invest or have shares in the public enterprises. From that also they are getting the dividend and profit. That amount also included in the public revenue. And the fourth one is special assessment of betterment levy. Sometimes for the welfare of the society or for the betterment lifestyle of the people, the government started some parks and public projects, isn't it? For that they are paying some amount. They will collect some amount. For example, if you go for a Rajaji park, you have to pay, collect the tickets. That is run by the Madurai Corporation. They are collecting entrance fees, isn't it? 2 rupees, 3 rupees for playing in the park and other things. Public projects, you are using the ring road, toll gates, you are paying the amount in the toll gates. Why you are paying the amount in the toll gates? For the public projects, for laying the road, to maintain the road, they need money. For that they are collecting the money from that. That is also revenue to the government. And gifts, grants and aids. This is given by central government, sometimes gives or grants and aids. During the pandemic period, we got money from the central government, isn't it? The government issued more than 4,000 crores to Tamil Nadu. So we are getting the grants and gifts, and sometimes for the betterment of the lifestyle of the farmers, the government is giving some grants every month, for once in 6 months, I think so, or monthly they are giving 2,000 rupees to each and every farmer of the Tamil Nadu people. They are getting, isn't it? So those money are coming from the grants. It is coming to the state government. So it's a revenue for the state government. And it is nothing but the state can rights to claim the property of the people, those who are not having without the heir. Heir means generation. That means the person, one who dies without the legal heir, the entire wealth will be goes to the government. அதாவது குழந்தை இல்லாம யாராவது இறந்து போயிட்டாங்க அப்படினா அவங்களுடைய சொத்து அவ்வளவு யாருக்கு போய்டும் கவர்மெண்ட்க்கு போய்டும் டாக்ட்ரைன் ஆஃப் லாப்ஸ் அப்படினு ஹிஸ்டரியில ஒன்ஸ் யூ ஹேவ் ஸ்டடிட் அதுதான் இது டாக்ட்ரைன் ஆஃப் லாப்ஸ் சோ இஃப் a person one who dies without the legal heir the amount will be goes to government so these are all the non tax revenue next we will see the canon of taxation in the next video.